A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about acid-base disorders. It includes four disorders, that is metabolic acidosis and alkalosis, respiratory acidosis and alkalosis. For the assessment of acid-base disorder, arterial blood gas analysis is required. In this arterial blood gas analysis, three parameters are important. First one is the pH. Second is the bicarbonate. And third one is the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, which represents dissolved carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. The normal range of pH, it is 7.35 to 7.45. The bicarbonate level, it is 22 to 26 millimole per liter. And partial pressure of CO2 or dissolved carbonic acid, it is 35 to 45 mmHg. So these are the normal values. For the assessment of acid-base disorder, first see the pH. If it is less than 7.35, it indicates acidosis. If it is more than 7.45, it indicates alkalosis. So this is the primary defect, acidosis or alkalosis. It is given by the pH. Then bicarbonate, this is metabolic component. This is base. If there is decrease in the base less than 22 millimole per liter, it indicates metabolic acidosis. And increase in bicarbonate level, it indicates metabolic alkalosis. Then dissolved carbonic acid or partial pressure of CO2. When carbonic acid level increases, it indicates respiratory acidosis. And if it decreases, it indicates respiratory alkalosis. Remember this partial pressure of CO2 as a dissolved carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. If acid increases, it is acidosis. If acid decreases, it is alkalosis. Now, the parameter which goes with the pH is the primary defect. Means, if bicarbonate level decreases and pH decreases, it is metabolic acidosis. If partial pressure of CO2 increases, that is acidosis, along with the decrease in the pH, it indicates respiratory acidosis. If there is increase in the pH and increase in the bicarbonate level, it indicates metabolic alkalosis. If there is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2 and increase in the pH, that indicates respiratory alkalosis. So these are the four main primary disorders of acid-base balance. Now coming to the compensation, it is explained by the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. In Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, pH is equal to pK plus log of base, that is HCO3, divided by concentration of acid, that is H2CO3, which is represented by the partial pressure of CO2. Suppose it is metabolic acidosis. The primary defect in the metabolic acidosis is decrease in the bicarbonate level. This is the primary defect. Or there is increase in the acid production. And to overcome this acid, this bicarbonate is utilized. That's why there is deficit of bicarbonate. So this is the primary defect. That is decrease in the bicarbonate. To buffer the acid which are produced in our body. Now in compensation what happens? If there is decrease in the bicarbonate level, this ratio is 20:1. The body will compensate by this mechanism, partial pressure of CO2. To maintain this ratio as 20:1, the carbonic acid or partial pressure of CO2 decreases. Means this is respiratory mechanism. Compensation is by the respiratory mechanism. In other words, it is a respiratory alkalosis, compensated by respiratory alkalosis. Means metabolic acidosis, it is compensated by respiratory alkalosis. It is compensated by respiratory. The numerator in the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, it is under metabolic control. And denominator, it is under respiratory control. Coming to the second disorder, that is metabolic alkalosis. The primary defect in metabolic alkalosis is increase in the bicarbonate level. Increase in the bicarbonate level. This is compensated by, there is increase in the bicarbonate level. So to maintain the ratio to 20:1, there is increase in the carbonic acid or partial pressure of CO2. So this is compensated by respiratory mechanism. Means in other word, metabolic alkalosis is compensated by respiratory acidosis. Means these both components, metabolic acidosis and metabolic alkalosis, they are compensated by respiratory mechanism. If there is acidosis, the carbonic acid level will decrease, and if there is alkalosis, carbonic acid level will increase by the respiratory mechanism, by hyperventilation and hypoventilation. Now coming to the respiratory acidosis. Respiratory acidosis. The primary defect in the respiratory acidosis is increase in the partial pressure of CO2. There is increase in partial pressure of CO2. To maintain the ratio, body will compensate by this metabolic component. It is by the renal mechanism. There is increase in partial pressure of CO2. In order to maintain this ratio as 20:1, the body will conserve, or kidney will conserve the bicarbonate level by renal mechanism. So respiratory acidosis, it is compensated by renal mechanism. Renal conservation of bicarbonate. In respiratory alkalosis, the primary defect is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2. There is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2. But to maintain the ratio, the body will decrease bicarbonate level by the renal mechanism. So compensation is by the renal mechanism by decreasing the bicarbonate level or increasing the excretion of bicarbonate level. Okay, so respiratory acidosis and alkalosis, they are compensated by the renal system by conserving the bicarbonate or by excreting the bicarbonate level. So this is known as compensation. You can remember it by easy way, means metabolic acidosis, it is compensated by respiratory alkalosis. Metabolic alkalosis, it is compensated by respiratory acidosis. Respiratory acidosis, it is compensated by metabolic alkalosis. And respiratory alkalosis is compensated by metabolic acidosis. Now coming to the causes of this metabolic and respiratory acidosis and alkalosis. Coming to the metabolic acidosis, where primary defect is decrease in the bicarbonate level. So here decrease in the bicarbonate and pH, it is less than 7.35. This is called as metabolic acidosis. Causes includes, there are two types of causes. High anion gap metabolic acidosis and normal anion gap metabolic acidosis. Anion gap means it is the difference between measured, it is the difference between measured cations and this is known as anion gap. It is difference between measured cations and measured anion. It contributes to the unmeasured anions. This measured cations contributes to the 95% and this contributes to the 85 or 86%. So remaining one contributes to the anion gap. It is due to the unmeasured anions. These unmeasured anions mainly include PSPO. That unmeasured anions includes protein anions, then sulfate, phosphate and organic acids. It is near about 12, normal is near about 12 millimole per liter. If it is range, it is 8 to 18 millimole per liter is the normal anion gap. Okay, so there are two types of metabolic acidosis, high anion gap metabolic acidosis and normal anion gap metabolic acidosis. Coming to the causes of high anion gap metabolic acidosis, it includes mainly the diabetic ketoacidosis, then lactic acidosis, renal failure, organic acidurias, and amino aciduria. In this condition, there is excess production of acid, and bicarbonate is utilized to overcome the acids or buffering that acids. That's why there is consumption of bicarbonate and decrease in the bicarbonate level that leads to the metabolic acidosis and decrease in the pH. In metabolic acidosis, there is associated hyperkalemia, increase in the potassium level. This is because there is increase in the hydrogen ion concentration in the extracellular fluid, and this exchange with the intracellular potassium, potassium from inside of the cell comes outside in exchange with the hydrogen ion to maintain the electrical neutrality, and there is increased potassium level in the extracellular fluid that leads to the hyperkalemia. So metabolic acidosis is associated with the hyperkalemia. This is important MCQ. And this is caution to be taken during the treatment of diabetic ketoacidosis when you give the insulin, because correction of diabetic ketoacidosis lead to the rapid hypokalemia. So monitoring of potassium is required in the insulin treatment when there is diabetic ketoacidosis. So diabetic ketoacidosis, lactic acidosis, renal failure, organic acidurias and amino acidurias, these are the causes of high anion gap metabolic acidosis. Then normal anion gap metabolic acidosis, it includes diarrhea, then it includes renal tubular acidosis from type 1, 2 and type 4. Then intestinal fistula, here also there is aspirin which causes high anion gap metabolic acidosis. So these causes are important for entrance point of view. There is MCQ on high anion gap metabolic acidosis and normal anion gap metabolic acidosis. So these are the causes of metabolic acidosis. Primary defect is decrease in bicarbonate level, decrease in the pH, and it is compensated by respiratory component, as it is metabolic acidosis, compensated by compensation. It is by respiratory component and respiratory component by hyperventilation. Due to the hyperventilation or Kussmaul breathing, which is rapid and there is increase in the depth and rate of breathing, that leads to the blowout of CO2 or wash out of the CO2, decreases the carbonic acid level and corrects the acidosis. So this is metabolic acidosis. Now coming to the metabolic alkalosis. The primary defect in metabolic alkalosis is increase in the bicarbonate, and there is pH, as it is alkalosis, pH is more than 7.45. This is the primary defect. The causes includes there are two types, chloride responsive and chloride resistant. So it includes vomiting, then upper GI tract obstruction, then Cushing syndrome, It includes Bartter syndrome, then adrenal tumors, etc. So these are the causes of chloride responsive metabolic alkalosis. These are chloride resistant metabolic alkalosis. This is primary defect, that is increase in the bicarbonate level. Compensation is by the respiratory component in the form of hypoventilation. To maintain the ratio of 20:1, if there is increase in the bicarbonate, the partial pressure of CO2 also increases by the hypoventilation. Retention of CO2 occurs in the respiratory compensation. Now coming to the third, that is respiratory acidosis. Respiratory acidosis. As it is acidosis, the pH, it is less than pH, it is less than 7.35, and it is respiratory component, so partial pressure of CO2, it is 45 mmHg. So pH is less, partial pressure of CO2 is more than 45 mmHg. This is the primary defect, that is increase in the partial pressure of CO2. The causes includes, it includes pneumonia, then asthma, bronchial asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases, then narcotics and sedatives, which causes depression of respiratory centers and paralysis of respiratory muscles. These are the causes of respiratory acidosis. There is retention of CO2 occurs, that's why there is increase in the partial pressure of CO2. Compensation, it is mainly by as it is respiratory acidosis, compensation is by the metabolic component, it is by the renal system. In renal system, the kidney will, so if you see the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation, this is the base and this is carbonic acid, means it indicates the partial pressure of CO2. If this parameter increases, the kidney will increase this parameter, means kidney will compensate by reabsorption of bicarbonate. So this is the compensation. Now coming to the next, that is respiratory alkalosis. In respiratory alkalosis, the primary defect is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2. Means decrease in the carbonic acid, and pH increases. So this lead to the respiratory alkalosis. The causes includes 3H, that is, it is alkalosis, means there is hyperventilation, hypoxia, high altitude, hysteria, then septicemia, meningitis, febrile conditions that lead to the respiratory alkalosis. hyperventilation that will blow out the CO2. So there is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2. If there is decrease in the partial pressure of CO2, kidney will also decrease the bicarbonate level. So it decreases the reabsorption of compensation is by the kidney. Kidneys will decrease the reabsorption of bicarbonate. It is by metabolic regulation. Compensation means kidney will excrete bicarbonate. So this is about metabolic acidosis, alkalosis, respiratory acidosis and alkalosis and their compensation. The metabolic component, it is compensated by the respiratory mechanism, and respiratory component, it is compensated by the kidney by increasing or decreasing the reabsorption of bicarbonate level. For the assessment of acid-base balance or imbalance, the first thing is look for the pH. The first parameter is first C for the pH, then C for the bicarbonate level, then partial pressure of CO2, then look for the electrolyte and anion gap. In this way you can assess the acid-base disorders. For the assessment, you require an instrument that is arterial blood gas analyzer. The sample is collected in the heparinized syringe under all standard operating procedure. Then if pH is less, it is acidosis. If more, it is alkalosis. If bicarbonate is less, it is acidosis. If it is more, it is alkalosis. If partial pressure of CO2, it is more, it is acidosis. If it is less, it is alkalosis. And anion gap. You may get a case in university examination on this disorder, that is on this one of the four disorders, that is metabolic acidosis, alkalosis and respiratory acidosis, alkalosis. Or you may get a long question, long answer question on the acid-base balance and imbalance. This topic is very, very important for entrance point of view. In entrance, you may get a case. For UG level, it is simple case of metabolic acidosis, alkalosis or respiratory acidosis and alkalosis. For entrance purpose, there are compensation. So metabolic acidosis compensated by the respiratory component. Metabolic alkalosis compensated by the respiratory component. Respiratory acidosis and alkalosis, they are compensated by the renal mechanism. So this is all about the acid-base disorders. Keep watching. Thank you.